Well, Dolly Parton fans, this one is for you.
Lipscomb University's Department of Fashion and Design is launching Dolly Parton and the Makers.
Dolly Parton and the Makers.
Dolly Parton and the Makers.
Dolly Parton and the Makers. My Life in Rhinestones.
It is a student-developed exhibit,
and they're giving their students some real-world experience from global superstar Dolly Parton.
Her fans can get an up-close look at some of her custom clothing.
Features 25 outfits, shoes, and accessories from Dolly's storied career.
I had no idea that it would be this big.
Doing work some graphic designers could only dream about. He's created a billboard in Nashville.
And so when you actually start seeing things come together, it's just been cooler than I can imagine.
Legend, the fashion icon. She's the best, right?
It looks really good. I was very proud.
42 students over 12 majors have worked since the spring to bring this exhibition to life.
How did you rate Dolly's closet?
Like nothing I have ever seen before. Come on, check that.
They are expecting about 6,000 people over 6 weeks while this exhibit is open.
Looks incredible. Yeah, maybe another round of applause for him, right? Well, hi everyone. My name is Lori Richard. And in addition to my current position of program manager at Nordstrom, I also have the privilege of being an adjunct professor here at Lipscomb for fashion merchandising. And this year, there are 8 seniors in our fashion department. 5 fashion design students, and 3 fashion and interior merchandising students as well. And tonight you'll see the tactical work and of the fashion design students by way of the runway. We also hear from each of the merchandising students. So for those of you, maybe you're not familiar with the term fashion merchandising, it would be helpful to know that this is the study of the business of fashion. And the business of fashion spans a really wide range of different career paths, and product planning and visual merchandising, as well as marketing, journalism, creative production, brand management, and of course, all aspects of retail. Our fashion and interior merchandising seniors also played a significant role in the production of tonight's event. And Darby George handled the marketing and PR, Charlotte Dix handled all internal communications, logistics, and run of show. And Bailey Sneddon served as our art director and stage manager. Here to share their experiences firsthand are Darby, Charlotte, and Bailey as their senior spotlights.
Hi there, my name is Darby George, and I'm a fashion interior merchandising major with a minor in entrepreneurship. My favorite fashion memory at Lipscomb was the trip we took to New York City last May. We spent a week navigating the busy streets, but we learned so much from all different aspects of fashion. We learned stuff from merchandising to textiles and design. It was really a bonding experience with our professors and peers. One of my favorite classes that I've taken at Lipscomb would be clothing construction. It's been so fun to learn how to make my own clothes, especially not being a design major. My goals for the future are to own my own boutique, and I can't thank Lipscomb Fashion enough for helping me prepare to get to where I'm at now. With my growing knowledge of buying, business, trend forecasting, and more, it feels amazing to know that I'll be confident to step into the professional world. And to that, I owe my professors and peers the biggest thank you.
I'm Charlotte Dix. I'm a fashion and interior merchandising major. One of my favorite experiences with Lipscomb Fashion started before I even got accepted into Lipscomb. I got a note from Charlotte and Sissy with a little square of paper and some directions on how to fold a paper crane. So I folded up the paper crane and sent it back to Charlotte, Poling, and Sissy. And shortly after, they sent me a picture of my crane displayed in one of the projects that they were working on. And the note said, "We've been praying for you, and we prayed for you when we put the paper crane that you folded into the display." When I received that letter back from Charlotte and Sissy, I was like, wow, they are so intentional. And I wasn't even a student at the time. So imagine the care and thoughtfulness that I'll experience as a student. And that has been so prominent during my experience here. All the professors really are caring and intentional about each of their students. Lipscomb has prepared me really well for the workforce. I have had two different fashion internships, and they've both gotten me experience in so many different facets of the fashion world. Not only have I had that professional experience, but I've also been able to travel to some of the big fashion hubs, like New York and Milan. In the future, I hope to use the knowledge I've gained here at Lipscomb as a merchandiser for some company. And I will truly miss all the classes I have with amazing professors and such talented and creative peers. I've loved working behind the scenes of this fashion show, and it's a great way to conclude my time here at Lipscomb.
Hi, I'm Bailey Sneddon, and my major is fashion and interior merchandising. When I think about my Lipscomb experience, it can't really be reduced to one memory. So I transferred into the program in my junior year, and I think that every experience, conversation, and connection that I've had was kind of all very pivotal to me. It all kind of just added up together. I've had the same position in the fashion industry picked out for myself since I was 18, and I think coming here really just opened my mind to things and like showed me that there's so much variety, and like I don't think that would have happened without the program here. The experiences this program has given me, like the Dolly Parton exhibit, the Atlanta Apparel Mart, and my internship, as well as just the incredible curriculum here, has really given me the confidence in myself as well as my professional ability, and I don't think that was something that was there before. As cheesy as it sounds, I think that the people that I've met since I've been here and then sometimes worked with has really just been the most pivotal thing for me. Also, the connections that I've built with the staff here and my professors. Charlotte Poling is literally an angel from above. And I'm so grateful that I've been able to connect with her, and I just owe her so much for all of the guidance and the support that she's given me since I've been here. I'm currently interning as the assistant to the art director and stylist Colson Horton. In this position, I've worked with organizations like Pottery Barn, Walmart, and Billboard. I've gotten some hands-on experience in interior design through 3D modeling lab projects, paint matching, and decorating, which has been really cool to exercise that aspect of my degree. And then I've also spent hours researching product development and then implementing that information. After this, I plan to continue my freelance wardrobe styling career in the film and music industries, which I have been doing for the last 3 years alongside my education. If you want to see more on that, you can go to baileysneddon.com. But truly, I'm so open to and feel so prepared for new experiences in the industry, and I have Lipscomb Fashion to thank for that. I'm just really excited to see where the universe takes me from here.
Yes, tonight we truly appreciate all the hard work of our fashion and interior merchandising students. They've done a super job keeping us all organized and behind the stage. The next part of our show features the work of our Clothing 1 and Clothing 2 construction classes. Our students come to us with a wide range of abilities and talents, and it is my joy to watch them as their confidence grows and their skills improve. And so tonight you'll see mostly projects from the class, but there are a few students who've worked independently and created things outside the class. And so now we're pleased to present the work of our youngest students.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Rebecca Dean. I am a professor and the lab manager for the program. One of my favorite things about my job is I get to work pretty closely one-on-one with students in the lab, especially with specialty techniques like embroidery, 3D printing, and laser cutting, which you'll see quite a bit of tonight. But for right now, I get the privilege and the honor of introducing our junior collections. These are featuring Annabelle Brown, Yusuf Najib, and Calissa Finn. And as juniors, these students are not even required to produce collections, but these three have gone above and beyond. They've put in a ton of extra hours in the lab. It's been so fun to watch them, and they've produced some really incredible things. So first up, it's going to be Annabelle Brown. Annie is from Colorado Springs, and her junior collection is inspired by Homer's Iliad. And she first read the poem in high school, and she was really inspired by just kind of stepping into a new world of seeing and understanding how people can overcome tragedy and really difficult things. So her pieces represent the muses, Thetis, Achilles, Patroclus, and Helen. So please enjoy Annie's junior collection.
Yeah.
job, Annie. All right, next we have Yusuf Najib. Yusuf is from right here in Nashville. He's a design major. His junior collection entails 6 pieces, each one representing a different character from the story of Cinderella. Yusuf loves storytelling and the way it creates human connection, and he especially loves Cinderella because it's a classic tale that gives people hope and inspiration. Please enjoy Yusuf's collection. Awesome job, Yusuf. I will say he has a work ethic unlike most people, and I am very impressed with just all the projects he is working on constantly in the lab. So well done there. Last but not least, we have Calissa Finn. Calissa is originally, she's from Houston, Texas, a design major, and she's also a competitive rock climber. And for her collection, she drew inspiration from rocks, her favorite mountain ranges. Her first look is inspired by Cerro Torre in Mount Fitzroy in Patagonia. Her second look is inspired by Mount Monument Valley, found in the U.S., and lastly, her third look is inspired by the lush Laojun Mountains in China. So please enjoy Calissa's junior collection.
Lemming, and I'm part of Dolly's team, have been for many, many years. As a professional stageware maker, it has been such an immense pleasure to be here for this past school year as artist in residence, adjunct professor, and I've had the immense pleasure of getting to know these students and helping them through this final hurdle in their career at Lipscomb. After being part of Dolly's creative team for so long, making her clothes, it has been an awesome experience to get to share it with these talented and driven people and help them along their path and learn new things and to sort of land where we are tonight, at least until their next step. I'm here to introduce the senior collection. We celebrate the culmination of years of hard work and dedication as we showcase the senior collections of our talented future fashion designers. Behind each stunning garment you see tonight lies countless hours of research, sketching, pattern making, and meticulous craftsmanship. These seniors have poured their hearts and souls into their collections, pushing boundaries, exploring new techniques, and infusing their unique perspectives into every stitch. So as we applaud their creativity, let's also recognize the passion and commitment that have brought these designs to life and the many, many hours it takes to do this sort of thing. Before each collection walks the runway, the designers will introduce themselves through their senior spotlight video, and you can learn more about them. These videos will reveal not only their collection inspiration, but also a bit about their time and experience here at Lipscomb. Ladies and gentlemen, the senior collections.
Hi, my name is Ashley Izquierdo Renderal. I am a fashion design major. I transferred to Lipscomb about a year and a half ago. Although my experience at Lipscomb was shorter, I enjoyed every second of it. In the beginning, I was very nervous, mainly because I came from a visual arts background. I didn't really have much knowledge in garment construction or sewing. However, I had a strong passion about the industry, and I always dreamt about bringing my designs to life. My most memorable experience here at Lipscomb was when our fashion department took a trip to New York City. It was actually my first time traveling to New York, so I had no idea what to expect, but it was the most beautiful experience. I got to bond a lot with my my classmates and my professors got to learn more about the industry and about all the different kinds of job opportunities. Last fall, I also got to have the opportunity to work at Justin and Murphy for my internship, and it was such a great experience to kind of dive in firsthand about what it's like to expect from the industry and kind of just see all the process and product design and work with really close with the designers. For my collection, I created 4 looks that represent the culture from the state my parents are from, which is Veracruz, Mexico. Veracruz is known for its very beautiful tropical environment and beautiful beaches. I like to dedicate this collection to my parents because they're the ones who support me and make me feel proud of who I am. And they're always there to support me in my journey and my career. And I hope you guys enjoy this collection. In the future, I hope that I could become a stylist and style all famous artists. I also look forward to being a part of a great community in the fashion industry. I'm really open to any opportunities out there that are waiting for me, but I am very excited to see what the future will come.
Volar a las 2 de la mañana. I'm Cindy Torres, and I'm a senior fashion design major. The most memorable experience for me at Lipscomb as a fashion design major was back in January when Professor Sissy and some of the seniors went on a short little trip to New York City to shop for our senior collection fabrics. And through this experience, we toured a lot of like the fabric stores and kind of went through like the whole process of what it is to go and search for these types of fabrics. So it kind of helped me learn more a little side of like the fashion industry and what it is, what it would be like to like search for fabrics and go shopping for them in the fashion industry. An impactful experience at my internship at Brides by Glitz Nashville had to be the consulting that went on. There was a lot of consulting going on as it was in bridal. And so the main thing that I learned was that you have to listen to the customer and what it is that they're looking for in order to create a good experience for them and to help them find what it is that they need. So the inspiration behind my collection was kind of blending my style and like what my Pinterest board and my Instagram feeds look like. When creating like outfits, I like to incorporate like more feminine but also masculine aspects. So for this collection, I kind of wanted it to be like a blend of those two and just like a mini wardrobe of like what I would wear and what pieces I would have in my closet. So I got inspiration from the designer Sandy Liang, as well as like the fashion house Acne Studios. And through this, I kind of tried to focus more on like what types of fabrics I chose, the colors, the closures, silhouettes, and like little details like that, as I kind of wanted it to be something that's like more personal to me. So after Lipscomb, I hope to be a part of a design team for a brand that I guess aligns with my values and what my style is. I also hope to be in like a more fashion forward city, as I feel like I can kind of immerse myself fully into my work and bring out a good outcome. I also found that at Lipscomb, I really enjoyed the design process. So through like the classes like flat pattern, clothing construction, as well as taking more business focused classes like merchandising and buying, I was able to kind of narrow it down to what it is that I enjoyed, which was the design process.
My name is Magnolia Baxter, and my major is fashion design. My favorite fashion memory is when we bought the industrial machines, along with the 3D printer and the embroidery machine. We were given a weird assignment to like have to use at least two of them in some weird way, shape, or form, and I decided to make a bag, and I made snake handles with the 3D printer. definitely random. I think that was one of my best creations, even though it wasn't a garment. Very fun times, I think. The most impactful memory at Lipscomb would be the New York City trip. Even though I'm from New York, we did a lot of different things I've never done in New York before. And one of them was touring all the buildings and like learning about the history. And then when we were going past Coach, somebody told me that I would be a great fit there. Thought that was really nice. It boosted my ego a little bit and made it like possible to understand like where I could be in the future. Made my dreams a lot more grand. My favorite memory at my internship at Canvas and Clothier was when I stuck up the hip of my boss when she was just doing an actual day in the city, which included a lot of walking, a lot of shopping, and then we met up with all of her partners and then some photo shoots. I went to her factories and then I met all of her workers. They liked me a little bit. They kept talking and saying a lot of random things. And when she came back, they hyped me up and everything like that. So that was really nice. And then also we did a fitting for her son because she was making his suit for his wedding. The inspiration behind my collection would be my name, thanks to my mother. It's magnolia, so it's a flower. So I just went the cliche route. I looked up some flowers, but I'm in love with the sky. So I did from sunrise to sunset to midnight. So it starts with the day and ends with the night, as you can see throughout my pieces, but they're all inspired by flowers. So it's called Floral Skies. My hopes and goals for the future would begin with just an easy job. I'm going to Puerto Rico after school. So like that's first step, which is great. And then I want to get connections. But end goal would be my business that I have made a plan for a while back, which is a fashion closet on wheels. So I'm just a stylist, but then with the money that I have left over or the funds that I get from any sponsorships or stuff like that, I'll be styling homeless people for job interviews so they can get a better chance at their future.
I am from Houston, Texas, and my major is fashion design. So the New York tour trip that we took in my sophomore year of college was very impactful and had a lot of cherished memories for me, because not only did we get to see so many industry professionals along the way, but it was really a bonding time for me and my classmates. I got to see their different personalities early on, and there was even a memory where some of us got separated on the New York subway, and like they had to like find which bus to take and like where to stop. It was very funny and I'll never forget it. And you know, Sissy and Charlotte treated us like we were their own children and really looked after us. So Yeah, it's something I'll never forget. So I really appreciate the opportunity the department gives for us to work with other majors to create fashion. In 2022, I did a project with Sean Worth, who's a graphic design major, and the engineering department for Creates What's Next. We worked with the engineering department to create a hat with a motorized bike that rode around the brim of the hat. And just the experience of working with engineering to like laser cut the bike pieces and put them together and brainstorm how the bike would move, it was just so enlightening and enjoyable for me. And that's the kind of design that I love doing, is just making pieces that are movable on the wearer. And if I hadn't participated in this program, I wouldn't have known that. So this past summer, I interned with the Kendrick Brothers in Georgia for their movie called The Forge. And it was such an amazing experience. Just not only the daily interactions with everyone there and seeing like how makeup and hair, costume and lighting have to work together to make an artistic vision for a movie come true, but also like it was a time for me to really build my faith and grow to appreciate the different personalities and talents that there are. I loved interacting with the extras and learning, you know, how they got there, what their hopes for the future were, and things like that. So my collection is called Promises. It is inspired by my faith and my walk with God. I know that sometimes thinking about the future and how uncertain it is, it can be, there's a chance for fear to creep in and kind of hold your heart and grip it. And I really want to encourage people looking at this collection that God knew them before they were put on this earth, and he can see them through any kind of difficulty that comes up. So each look is a promise. I have grace, adventure, sustenance, and milk and honey, things like that. These are things that I can rely on when nothing else is reliable. And in God's word, these are things that I am promised and I can take with me wherever I go. So my hope for the future is really to find a niche in the fashion industry that fulfills me. I really like the ideation process and really detailed work. I think doing things like costume designing for a high fashion movie or designing for red carpets for musicians and movie stars would be something I'm interested in. The resources and experiences I've gotten through the fashion department here has exposed me to various job possibilities that I never considered. And it showed me kind of also the logistical side and the business side of developing a brand and managing it. These are lessons that I can take with me wherever I go, no matter what I decide to do.
My name is Jolie Anderson, and I'm a fashion design major. My favorite fashion memory is actually my freshman year. I was in Clothing Construction 1, which was my first ever sewing class ever. And I was sitting there, and Sissy was going over all the, like, things that we needed and all the syllabus and all that. And I remember just being so, like, awestruck that this was my major and the route of my life and that I was getting to study this for 4 years. And I just remember, like, almost crying and just being so filled with joy. And I went up to Sissy afterwards and told her that. And whenever I, like, have a hard time in the sewing lab, I just think back to that and always inspires me to keep going. My most impactful memory at Lipscomb was going to Italy with the fashion department. It was just, like, a wonderful experience. I mean, we got to run around and look at art museums and learn about fashion in a villa in Florence and travel to Milan, and it was just a wonderful one-of-a-kind experience that definitely inspired me. So my internship was with The Chosen. It was just a really amazing experience to be a part of something with such a big purpose and mission behind it, as well as learning so much not only about, like, fashion and costuming, but also just the film world in general. It was just an amazing, one-of-a-kind experience. My collection is called The Stories of Man Written in the Stars, and it's basically going over the different mythologies that different cultures use to describe how stars came to be. So each dress is inspired by a different culture's mythology. So I have some from Greek, some biblical inspiration, and just all lots of fun things. So my goal in the future is to find something that I can express myself creatively and to be able to design. I love couture and I love dresses in general. So anything that I get to make pretty dresses with, I'll be happy.
Wow. Let's give another round of applause to all these fabulous designers and students. to end our show, the models will come through one more time. Here we go.
Department of Fashion and Design and the entire College of Entertainment and the Arts, thank you, Luke and Terry. There was lots of work that happened there, lots of work throughout the last 4 years, lots of work throughout the last year, so thank you for being here. Thank you. Thank you. I want you to know that the students, the designers, and their work will be outside. If you'd like to take a closer look, other than that, thank you so much for joining us, and enjoy your night.
If you wanna run away with me, I know a galaxy, and I can take you for a ride. I had a premonition that we fell into a rhythm where the music don't stop. Glitter in the sky, glitter in my eyes, shining just the way I like. If you're feeling like you need a little bit of company, you met me at the perfect time. You want me, I want you, baby. My sugar boo, I'm levitating.